Welcome along to the most populous city in North America and home now to the Mexico City Grand Prix. It's a sellout crowd as usual here at one of the shortest circuits on the Formula One calendar. So who, I wonder, will the crowd cheer on today to the top step of the podium? The Autódromo Hermanos Rodríguez, 2.6 miles of track that allows drivers to take full advantage of their cars, reaching speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour and providing lots of opportunities for overtaking. The circuit features 17 corners, 10 to the right and the remaining 7 going to the left. Alongside me once again for coverage of today's race, it's none other than the great Anthony Davidson. Let's start with Alfa Romeo. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do. And that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And it's Charles Leclerc in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Moore, Gasly, Lando Norris, and Kvyat, Hamilton, Albon, Ricciardo, and Valtteri Bottas, Perez, Sainz, Jordan King. They've taken a grid penalty. And Stroll, Russell, De Vries, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Kevin Magnussen, Ocon, and Nicholas Latifi. Now, it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Okay, there's a good chance you can finish in a point-scoring position today. Good luck.
Seeing any technical issues coming off the practice start. Watch the RPM on the full start. We don't want to bog down. threat of rain for the time being. Conditions looking good. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch.
We'll be right back.
DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Use your overtake button. The car behind is gaining on you by 5/10 a lap. We pretty much burned off our excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down. dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Was a 1:15.6. Start losing some tire grip around now. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. Virtual safety car, reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta. Pitting this lap then, come into the pits at the end of this lap. Exit now. Stop today. One stop left in our strategy. Drop your speed. Our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. We'll be right back. Okay, clear. Seconds. 14th position. You're in 14th position. Sainz is ahead of you. Okay. Gap ahead is 2.5 seconds. They're on old softs. Stroll behind. The gap to the car behind is 1.6 seconds. They're on old softs. Your pit window opens in 16 laps time. 27 laps to go. Use of the overtake button and see what you can do. They're in fifth. The difference is 8.8 seconds. They're on old softs. We think they've got two stops remaining. The time last lap was a 1:21.3. Of an impact. Let me know you're okay. second is 2.3 seconds. Antonio in the pits. Your overtake button more, it's time to utilize some of this energy. teammate by 19.8 seconds. Engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. For now, everything's looking good. Let's use overtake and burn some of this energy. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the softs. A teammate behind is 13.0 seconds. In this lap, push now. gap behind us is 13.1 seconds. They're on old softs. Their tyres are 9 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 16.4. That last lap was a 1:16.4. Was a 1 minute 16.2. Kvyat behind, okay, the gap behind is 10.0 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 5 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:16.3. We'll be right back. to Mix 2, fuel to Mix 2. We're leading our teammate by 23.4 seconds. Spare energy, use your overtake button. Behind is 21.4 seconds. They're on old softs. They're in ninth. The time last lap was a 1 minute 15.7. Laps of fuel remaining. Have deteriorated significantly at this point. You're dropping a second a lap to the car behind, 1 second. two laps of fuel left. Seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 12 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:15.6. That last lap was a 1:17.9. This is your final lap of the race. At the moment, the car behind us is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap. Worked hard for that one. Congratulations.
That's it for another Grand Prix and a fantastic win for Alfa Romeo. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Looks like they're on their way out to the podium now, and what a result this is! And a popular one with the crowd as well. Great stuff to see the Alfa Romeo team on top here today. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. With today's outstanding performance, Pierre Gasly becomes the new leader of the Drivers' Championship. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
My Driver of the Day has to be, no question, Antonio Giovinazzi. Such an assured drive from one of the sport's newer stars, and a performance he can be very, very proud of.
Nothing can challenge the leaders of the Constructors' Championship at this point, but, and it's another title in the bag for Red Bull. After a long and hard-fought season, they've built an astonishing car this year, and the glory they'll be taking back to Milton Keynes is fully deserved. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today, as they make their way up the standings. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.